Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day. This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Insurance. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Good Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon. I trust and hope that you enjoyed your holiday yesterday, even though I think most people only know what it is in terms of it being Whit Monday and not why it is. My son asked me, but that don't stop us from enjoying a day off. So I hope and trust you had a wonderful day. By the way, today is the birthday, the 31st birthday of my firstborn child and my junior, Zhivargo Sean Laing Jr. His birthday is today, so I'm wishing him a happy birthday here on the radio. The young man been growing up a long time. So happy birthday to him. And guess what? I have another one. His birthday will come up on Friday. Yeah, I was busy in them months, 9 months early, I guess. So they all born around that time. If you want to give us a call today on the show, the numbers to do so are 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259 from the Family Islands. You can call us on 242-300-5720. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. That's 439-3043. We are live on Cable Bahamas, channel 969. That's the way my mother listens to the show. Or you can catch us on BTC Flow channel 612. That's BTC Flow channel 612. I spent 20 years of my life directly involved with the front lines of politics. What do I mean by that? I mean party politics, right? In 1996, I was asked to run for the Free National Movement in the upcoming election in 1997. And I won my seat in that election in the Fort Charlotte area, and then served as a member of parliament for Fort Charlotte and a cabinet minister from 97 to 2002. Contested the election in 2002 for re-election and lost, and went on my merry way, but continued to no doubt nonetheless be active in the political arena. And then in 2007, I ran again, and that time in the Marco City constituency. I won the seat and served as a member of parliament for Marco City and then the Minister of State and the Ministry of Finance from 2007 to 2012. And then really lived a quieter life But, you know, was now nonetheless still actively a part of the political happenings. Some people close to me who felt like I had potential for leadership in the party or in the country believed and said that I didn't seem to have fire in my belly for that. Like, in other words, I wasn't ambitious enough for that. But depending on how they viewed life, they were right. They were right. Because for me, politics was never a thing I sought for any personal sense of accomplishment or achievement or anything of that nature. That's the God honest truth. It's not, it was never something that I was in love with. When I did it, I did it with all my heart, but it wasn't something that that was an affection for me. So when I wasn't doing it, it didn't matter. And when I was doing it, mattered. Now that I'm not doing it, it doesn't matter. If I ever do it again, it'll matter. Because I believe it's something that if you're in, you're in. If you're out, you're out, right? But there was always something about politics. Not that this is the natural tendency of politics. It's not. But it tends to ferment in politics, because politics is a struggle for power. And it's a struggle for power through the acquisition of popularity. So nothing plays on ego more than politics. Do you hear what I said? Politics is a struggle for power. And that power you get in a democracy by personal popularity. Popularity is the currency of democratic politics. And so therefore, it is not unusual that ego and manipulation becomes a big part of the political happenings. It's human nature. And wherever humans find themselves in a struggle for power that they have to get by popularity, certain things ferment, right? And so what bothered me most about politics was people have no difficulty expressing, there are many people, not everybody, but people have no difficulty expressing the most laudable platitudes on planet Earth when they are giving public speeches. No difficulty talking about how we must be united, how we must love one another, how we must care for one another, how they're so passionate about the country and people. And in the background, they're doing all kind of skullduggery. All kind of skullduggery. No difficulty ripping people to shreds, lying on people, making things up, bringing up nonsense and politics, even if it's true. Why? Because for them, whatever it takes, I did not have that in me. I was not a whatever it takes fella. I couldn't do it. And that's the goal. That's just true. You guys couldn't do it. Right? And so it's the skullduggery. Right? Think about this for a moment. I want you to, those of you who have been around politics for a long time in this country, ask yourself this question. Whether it was with regard to party politics, or it was regard to national politics, how often have you heard contenders really battling over the ascendancy of their ideas? When was the last time you saw memes saying, oh, this one said that their policy on this would be that, and so forth and so forth, and I think that's just great. When was the last time you... But you'll see, he said that she did. You'll see all kind of crap. It would have nothing to do with politics out there because apparently the race for leadership, not just in parties, but across the political spectrums, and not just in the Bahamas, it seems like the race for leadership is now a race for being the least worst of the worst people. Not the best among the best. Not being the goodest among the good. And not as bad as him. Not as bad as her. Or, let me tell you why you should pick me. Because him, her, they bad. They this, they that. They're everything negative. Oh, but what are your thoughts about running the country? Oh, no, them don't mind. No, I asked you, what are your... you can't get that. Skullduggery, man. And trust me. The skullduggery is going on. It is. It is. I ain't calling no skullduggerous names today, but the skullduggery is going on. Because weak people cannot present themselves. I'm talking about anybody across any political spectrum, in any political sphere, in any part of the world. Weak people, unattractive leadership can only stand, they believe, if the other people fall. If the other people are more muddy than them. If the other people are less accomplished than them. It's the only way. It cannot be that, you know, he, she are fantastic people, but I'm just more fantastic than them. And let me explain why. You will seldom hear that argument in our politics today. Seldom. Oh, when they were in office, just the crap they did. When they were, now, listen, no, what did you do while you were in office? No. When they were in office, This is the inspirational leadership and politics of our time that is supposed to move thousands and thousands of Bahamians to lift themselves to higher ground. Okay. Let's see how that works out. It don't make no difference to me who you are on any side of the political divide, in your party or outside. If that is the modus operandi that you have, trust me when I tell you. Don't waste your time on this side of the wall. I am not participating in it. I'm not. I mean, you, if that's you, if that is your thing, don't look in my direction. Don't look in my direction for no support, and don't look in my direction for giving other people encouragement to support. It just don't make no sense. It makes no sense to be taking a race to the bottom. Is at the bottom, everybody's dead. Everybody's filthy. Everybody's worse off at the bottom. And who's trying to get there? Nonsense. I mean, those of you who participated in politics for a while, when was the last time, I can tell you, when was the last time you were inspired by the competition between the players? Mm-hmm. When was the last time you looked at and said, wow, that's a tough choice? Not tough choice because I don't want to vote for none of them, but tough choice because I would vote for either of them. M&M, PLP, this one the leader, that one the leader. No problem. Who great guys. What do I decide? F&M contestant for leader, F&M contestant for leader. Both five of them. Great guys. PLP contestant for leader, PLP contestant for leader. I'd vote for great people. No. What ain't what bees be talking about? If I'm wrong, you let me know. Please, I'm happy to be wrong. This text says, good afternoon, Mr. Laing. It is a beautiful day in Nassau with some much needed rain. We are also having some thunder, lightning, wind, and rain right now. I was told that actually. Or like I said, but I'm so glad for the rain. Yes, yeah. Even that, my friend used to say, man, everybody got to eat, including the trees. Good day, Zhivargo. Always love listening to your show. Can you kindly have your producer check your microphone level? It's much lower than the commercials. Thanks. Okay. The microphone is the way it always is. The only thing I could tell you is, generally speaking, commercials, even if you watch them on YouTube and elsewhere, they are always higher than the other portions of the production. That's a natural thing. If you can't hear me well, then that's a different story. This text says, no, it's okay. They need to check their volume. I thought so. Because and everybody else is telling me it's fine. Nothing else. Yeah, so the skullduggery. So let me, I told you all this before. The politics we play very much reflect what we believe to be true of the people who vote. So if you think politics is nasty, dirty, shallow, and all that kind of stuff, that's because you require nasty, shallow politics. That's what they believe. Because if they thought that you would be turned off by it, they wouldn't do it. But if enough of you are participants in it, well, why would they stop? They're giving customers what the customers want. Why else would a political party or operatives of a political party or operatives of a political person send out a nasty meme, a downgrading this or that? Because they believe you, whose vote people are seeking, will eat that up. That will change your mind or persuade you. That's why they do it. It's the only reason why. What else would be the reason why? Just being downright personally nasty, selfish and terrible. That's the reason why some people would vote for that. That's true. Some people. But in the business of politics, people are trying to influence people. Somebody walked up to me the other day and said, Zhivargo, did this person campaign with you in Fort Charlotte? I said, yes, they did. So you sure? So yes, they did. So everybody's talking dead bad about you. I said, what's new? I wouldn't lose 1 second of sleep over nonsense like that, because who's participating in politics? Human beings. Who are these human beings? The same people who drive Almighty God to flood the planet. Same people. But while you have those people who would choose that means and that way of operating and carrying on, guess why? For somebody. They gotta talk bad about you because they're trying to big up somebody. Really? Your person is so small, so insignificant. Your person has so little shine that you got to dirty up somebody else for them to shine? Oh, I see. No, that's not what the politics we want, man. You got to be able to say, listen, you see them two people? Boy, I love those ideas they got. Love their approach. Difficult choice. I'd vote for either of them, but I got to make a choice. We have a call on the line. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you. Hi, go ahead, caller. Hello. All right. Not sure what's going on there. See, at the end of the day, I promise you, none of the nastiness played by any party or person or persons in politics will advance one single betterment of this country. Will not do so. Cannot find means to expand this economy. Cannot find means to grow the prosperity of this country. Cannot find means to lift up the undeveloped portions of this country. Cannot find means to cause some young person desperately in need of skills to
get a job, desperately in need of education to get a job, None of that crap can add a single advancement to this nation. But if that's what tickles you, be tickled. Be tickled. If that's what gets you going, be going. No problem. And ain't nobody can tell me nothing. I know what I know, and I know what I know. And I see what I see, I know what I know. Some of the most nasty, difficult, terrible, malicious people on planet Earth participate in our politics. And it's awful. It's terrible. They are terrible. They are. They've chosen the worst parts of the human nature to be on display for the benefit of power. Disgraceful. Disgraceful. The noble men and women of our nations, our ancestors, scoff at them. Be disappointed. We plead with them to find higher ground. We're not perfect. None of us. We're not always noble. None of us. None of us. None of us. None of us. None. Zhivargo Laing included. Surely. See, in the participation of public life, the stakes, the margins are abundantly higher. And our leaders are wrong and get it wrong. When their approach is wrong and get it wrong. Because leadership matters. And if John Maxwell is right, it sets a cap on everything. A cap on everything. And your leadership practice before you take office is a demonstration will do when you are in office. We've been there, done that, seen that pretty trick before. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
Reliable and impactful printing services, look no further. Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life. We stand by our quality products that is second to none. Our affordable pricing and friendly, efficient staff makes Printmasters the ultimate choice for all your printing needs. We can deliver any type of printing services, from banners to booklets to business cards, can print it.
Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life.
Located at the Nassau Guardian Building, telephone 302-2361.
Looking for a breakfast that will wake up your taste buds and kickstart your day? Well, Burger King Nassau has got you covered with the new Angry Crust Sandwich. Made with fluffy eggs, melted cheese, jalapenos, a spicy sauce, and your choice of ham, sausage, or bacon on a warm croissant. Make it a combo and add our signature hash browns and your choice of coffee, tea, or orange juice for a great way to start your day. Spice up your breakfast with the new Angry Crust Sandwich combo only at Burger King Nassau.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I'm so glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon. If you wish to give us a call, the numbers are 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043.
three from the Family Islands, you can give us a call on 300-457-20. And I know there are those listening to me, some who are cheering and saying, yes, Mr. Laing, I agree with you. And then there are some of them, some of the ones who practicing what they practicing, saying they wish that blah, 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 I'm going to go sit down, blah, 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 blah. No problem. No problem. I understand. I understand. The Commonwealth of the Bahamas has thousands of unemployed people. Thousands. Not hundreds, thousands of unemployed people. It has thousands of people who cannot be employed with available jobs, which makes them unemployable at this time. Whether it is their attitude or their skill set or whatever, they are unemployed. Thousands. Thousands of Bahamians are underemployed, meaning that they have qualifications capable of occupying a job that fits with those qualifications, but there are no jobs available. So they're taking the one job that they could get, which is a noble thing on their part, but they are not able to earn value that is attendant to the skill set that they have. Thousands of people find themselves in that circumstances. Thousands of business people wringing their heads, struggling, trying to figure out how to find the right company I need to have done. Thousands of people in this kind of an economic conundrum. On whose head does leading us out of that fall? I didn't say who alone, but who, on whose head does it fall? Falls on the leadership of your country. Either through vision, or through imagination, or through encouragement, or through incentives, or whatever, it falls on them to send the country in another direction. And while we are trying to win the leadership of the parties, while we are out there playing our politics, whose attention is to be done? How do we do this? How do we find the prosperity that truly lifts this boat and all the people in it? So that young people don't fear, listen to me. A substantial number of young people are no longer interested in living in this country. A substantial number no longer interested in living in this country. They don't see how it can take care of them, how it can give them anything, and neither are they inspired to think how they can give to it. When was the last debate you heard about that in your politics? What was the last policy statement you heard from the peoples about that? Yeah, but them whisper campaigns. You can hear, but you can see them memes. You can see them all dug up videos. I have to tell you, I think Michael Pintar has had to say it, and so has Dr. Menes. If I do not get elected, I shall remain faithful to the party. Now, the fact that you have to say that, why you have to say that? Why is it necessary to say that? Because why? Why? Why would you have to say such a thing? You didn't. Did Barry Christie have to say such a thing when he was running for leadership? Philip Galanis? Yeah. You know why? Because this is the environment we now live in. where people have seen, if you don't get to play, you take your ball and go. Or you break bottle on the court, so nobody else can play. Shameful, graceful, lack of leadership, lack of maturity, display of leadership. It's okay if you decide to quietly go your way, say, you know, well, I've lost, and so I'm no longer really in the front lines like that, and so forth and so forth. And you can provide your quiet support, however you just choose, et cetera. Or when you decide that you ain't get your way and you can't go bust up things, well, that's a different story altogether. Kind of leadership required to lead us onward, forward, and together is far more profound than many, many things. Coalesce a group of people toward common cause. Listen to me, to bring people together, not rip them apart. Nonsense talk, I for this one, I for that one. Yes, you can be for people and support people, but you have to understand the limits of that. In contest of ideas that you have chosen, whose ideas you subscribe. But beyond that, how dare you think and look on that other person as some enemy of the cause, that other person as not with us, and speak so disparagingly of them. You need to grow up. Stop your wicked nonsense. I even can tell you, don't be mad at me today. Child, be mad, yeah? Be mad. Be upset. It ain't gonna stop me from saying what I'm saying. But be upset. When you are amongst people, and even on a team, everybody don't like everybody. I sat in the cabinet of the Bahamas, I know some people didn't like me. When I asked them nothing, I heard what they said. Times, not a single soul would know, though. I heard what they said. Why, that didn't matter to me. You got a cause. My leader was Hubert Alexander Ingram. I was attentive to his vision for the country and my role and part in it. And wherever I needed to work with others to get that accomplished, then so be it. You liking me ain't causing me no sleep. Or disliking me, that ain't no problem. But that is more display. When you dislike somebody, that is more commentary on you and where you are in your life than it is on the person. Can I tell you that again? Being envious or jealous of people, first of all, when you are jealous, just so you know, when you are jealous of somebody, you simply would like to have what that person has. And it conjures up some not so positive feelings in you. That's jealousy. It's when you want what somebody has and you're prepared to harm them to get it. That's different. That envy is dangerous. It's the most dangerous emotion of all. Right? Watch envious people. They're dangerous toward you. But when we embrace those kinds of attitudes, it is more commentary on us than it is on the people toward whom we feel jealousy or envy. Because it is demonstrating a choice we have made to bow to our lesser angels our darker sides. And boy, when you are, see, if you are not the leader and you bow that way, you could cause damage, but the damage is more often limited. When you are a leader of a party and of a country, and that's your mindset, y'all don't want me to recount for y'all the multitude where the damage caused has been substantial. Because you could recall it for yourself. Never choose a spiteful, envious, malicious leader. Never choose a spiteful, envious, malicious, or insecure leader. Don't do it. Don't do it in your church. Don't do it in your school. Don't do it in your business, and don't do it in your politics. You will forever regret making that choice. Don't mean everything will fall apart, mind you. But what it means is we ain't gonna come together as it should. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I trust and hope you have a good little break. We can take a break for news and we'll be back. See you after the break.
Come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever, let me know that you're not alone. Holla if you feel like you've been down the same road.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas. It's Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
For fast, reliable, and impactful printing services, look no further. Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life. We stand by our quality products that is second to none. Our affordable pricing and friendly, efficient staff makes Printmasters the ultimate choice for all your printing needs. We can deliver any type of printing services, from banners to booklets to business cards. You name it, we can print it.
Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life.
Located at the Nassau Guardian Building, telephone 302-2361.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon. If you want to give us a call today, and I trust you will, you can call us on 323-6232. That's 323-6232 or 325-4316, 325-4316, or 325-4259. You can text us on 422-4796. 422-4796, or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. That's 439-3043. You know, when you get involved with frontline politics, you have a decision to make, right? You have to decide in your approach to politics the kind of person you are going to be. So when you first get in, because you are virtually an unknown quantity, everyone basically feels like they have an opportunity to shape and to mold you, to influence the direction and approach you take. So it is not unusual to get unsolicited advice, unsolicited information from people who are hoping one way or the other to be able to influence your trajectory, your direction, your choices in politics. And in the course of meeting such people, you meet some very noble people whose only desire is to see you flourish, to see you do well. They, if you're young, they're thrilled for this opportunity you have, and they want you to stand out and stand up and be someone admirable. And so they give you advice and counsel along those lines. They try to help you see what is what and who is who and what to be careful about and what to go after and so forth and so forth. They give you that advice. They are the angels of politics. They're angels, that's right. I didn't say they're perfect human beings and what have you. I said they're angels, right? And then you have those people who are very narrowly focused on their own interest. Can I say that again? Their hope and prayer is, with you, they will rise. With you, they'll get something. With you, they'll become something. That's just the truth. That's just the reality of things. That's just the way it is. And their approach to politics is not to avoid anything dirty or to avoid anything terrible or tragic. Their approach is to win. Let's win. Let's win. Right? And so they don't mind whispering in your ear, you see how she, him? They don't mind doing that. And they'll leave you and go whisper in somebody else, yeah, the same kind of thing, but only against you. When I became a member of parliament and in a constituency, you know, there were those who say, sadly, that former MP was this and that and the next thing and the next thing. What is my witness? When Michael Pindar became member of parliament, I said to him, now listen, when you become member of parliament, you will hear, not seeing Zhivargo, he this, that, and the next thing. Only remember, when you are no longer a member of parliament, they'll whisper the same thing in the next place in there. This is human beings. I don't regard it with no kind of malice. They are human beings. Many of us, we choose paths that are not so noble. And in politics, it gets raw. My mother is 85, 86 years. She could tell you. You know, one of the things my mother told me? My mother used to tell me, when I was a young, much younger man, my mother used to say, my mother was very active in politics. She said, Shabab, you know why I can't? Well, you know what I disliked about that certain person? I disliked how they brought grown men down even to their knees to cry. So my mom used to say, I don't like that. And that's just what you get sometimes in politics. Why am I talking this way? Because we can do better. We can choose better. Nobility. A noble talk in politics for public speeches. How about them private speeches? You know, with a smaller audience of people. How about you not buy in to all of that little whisper campaign and all that kind of stuff? Say, listen, we don't want to do that. We don't want to play that kind of thing.
How about you inspire people to do better? How about we do that? Because we can do better. We can choose better. And if we do, we'll be better. All of us. I didn't say perfect. I said better. Because we need better. So the F&M campaign is going on. Somebody asked me, said, Mr. Laing, you think PLP working with Dr. Minister? I said, well, how would I know that? I would figure that they think they're better off with him. I said, okay. And I have no reason to believe it's true. I don't have any. But if that is true, there you go. Skullduggery. Skullduggery, right? Because why? Right? Why would you even want to be in? Why would you even want to participate? Now, if I listen to some of my friends, well, very supportive of the PLP, if I listen to them and their public commentary, they themselves have expressed the view that they might be abundantly better off if Dr. Minnis is leading in the next election. That's what they say. And ain't no few of them will get up and talk. When? In fact, in the House of Assembly, when he walked inside the room, he got applause from the government of the Bahamas people. Nah, there goes the real leader. Mr. Pinta, I can't get that. What the saying go? The enemy of my enemy is my friend. I always tell people, listen, if my opponent wants me to do a thing, I shall not do that thing. If my opponent thinks that something is good for me, I will think it's not good for me. My opponents, they are not interested in my success. They're interested in their own success. Right? So could the PLP be working with Pinta to keep Minnis out, who is known to be able to win? Okay. So, you know, this is a cross-eyed statement. Could the PLP be working with Pinta? You have to be cross-eyed to say this, right? Metaphorically. So could the PLP be working with Pinta to keep Minnis out, who is known to be able to win? You know, it is also true. Mr. Minnis has also proven that he knows how to lose, just like me. So which is it? He won in 2017, and he lost in 2021. So he's batting 500. He's batting one or two. Which side of that equation are you talking about? And the light out, the water off, hyperinflation, etc. The Pindad was with Minnis when they put 12% on our food and said nothing. Well, first of all, they put 12% on your food. What was Pindad supposed to say? I mean, how silly a statement is that? He was in the government. So what you should say is, Pindad does put 12% on the food. That's how it goes. Right? Was Zhivargo Laing not in the F&M administration when BTC was privatized? So what did you want me to say? You wanted me to come out and be against it? Come on, man. You must be more intelligent than that. Stop your nonsense. Politics.
the way it gets played sometimes. So uninspiring, as some people say. And yet, sometimes inspiring. So let me tell you what's going on now. They ready themselves for the FNM convention, June 1. No more important people on planet Earth but contenders than the would-be delegates to the convention. No more important people. They shall be approached, wined in some instances, dined in some instances, listened to with meeting after meeting with them. They'll have operatives reach out, swayed for vote. Now, let me tell you how tricky it is. If you are confident that you will win, if you're confident that you will win, you have to both display the confidence that you will win while at the same time not appearing to be so confident that you will win that, one, people think you're cocky and taking them for granted, and two, people think that you don't need them to go vote for you anymore because you have so many votes. So you have to tread very carefully for the arrogant. The display of humility is going to try their very souls. For the humble, the inability to display confidence is going to try their very souls. It's like walking that tightrope over the Grand Canyon. Every little word, every little gesture, every hello or failure to say hello becomes a thing. Who are this one upset? You get calls. You need to talk to this one, but you need to have a word with that one. You need to speak to that one. It's a minefield of human feelings. And you are tiptoeing it. It is a very let me tell you something. You see Mr. Bindad, you see Mr. Dr. Minish, stress can't done. Don't mind up. You learn to demonstrate calm. You learn to show cool. Boy, dealing with human beings, you got to swallow up, swallow so much. Every day somebody comes to you, so-and-so telling people X, Y, and Z about you. And you have got to decide not merely how you're going to react to that overtly, but how you're going to deal with what that has done to you inside. Because you see these politicians, you see these people, these are people, these are human beings. Their feelings get hurt just like they just hurt people's feelings. And some their skin, the skin is thin. Can't take much. Don't mind they send on the right way, but they go home and stew in that hurt and feeling, and if they get an opportunity, they will show you. But they're just human beings. They are human beings with extraordinary opportunities to lead other human beings. And they have to stew in the sometimes waters of nobility of politics, but sometimes in the sewage of politics. And their friends, all you have to deal with it. You don't feel sorry for them. You don't feel sorry. They chose this. I'm just giving you an inside picture. Just telling you. Right? So sometimes the same way politicians feel when it's time for the general election, this is how these contenders feel in the way the convention. Why they look at that listen? Oh my goodness, I ain't called this one yet to get that vote. Right now, but that's a menace person, but that's a Pentad person. I was talking to someone in the last election, and they were saying how one of the candidates was going to had some people going to visit a house, and the candidate said, no, you don't need to go there. That's Zhivargo and Ingram people. Devil. The Zhivargo and Ingram people. What about that mean? You can't get a vote from a Zhivargo and Ingram people. And you in the FNF? What? Something wrong with that. Something definitely wrong with that. This is what happens. This is the game. This is the challenge, right? You think you among friendlies when you about you among frenemy. I thought that was a friendly. No, that's a frenemy. So this is it at its lowest ebb. Said Laing, I agree with your sentiments of the characteristics of some in politics. What's baffling, we must still refer to these individuals as honorable when we know better. Yeah. Well, if you want to find any comfort, it is not them you are referring to as honorable so much as their office. And so the office remains when the person leaves, only to be occupied by another. So it is the honorable office that they hold. That's why you don't call them honorable afterwards. Unless they did y'all know this? Unless they spent 2 terms or 10 years in it. And listen, they're not automatically honorable. They have to apply to be so declared. For instance, I could do that. I could literally apply to have and use the title honorable, the Honorable Zhivargo Sean Laing, since I have been in office for 8 years, for 10 years, for two terms. And I will not do so. That's just my choice. This is my personal choice. That's not than doing this, right? You know, but that, again, even in that, the title is being referred to the office I held as an honorific. Really, it's an honorific, right? And, you know, so because I couldn't get it in my person, I had to get it because of my standing of 10 years in as a cabinet minister. So listen to this. Say, boy, why you talk about yourself so much? Stop rowing every day. You are not the only being in the House of Assembly. But only you talk every day about yourself. You are a hater. You'd rather say, what do you want me to talk about? You want me to talk about you? Send me some information so I can talk about you. I only talk about myself when it bears reference to something else. And if you said that I talk about myself every day and you listen to the show every day, I'm talking about myself, you listen to the show, there's something wrong with you. I wouldn't do it. His text says, not sure what today's topic is. Electricity was off for 3 hours. In Freeport, ooh, yeah, electricity wasn't off for long, but it kept the thing. So I asked somebody who knows about these things, and they said that after Hurricane Dorian and those, because they used to have so much damage because of, you know, whatever the systems do to try to protect itself. Anyway, they got more sensitive equipment to try and avoid some of that damage. And so when the weather gets bad, you get dipped. It says 36 minutes ago, they posted a message that it was due to lightning. I would really like to know how power companies in the U.S. keep power on through all kinds of lightning storms. Stack says, Mr. Laing, I do believe that the PLP is well aware that if Dr. Minnis runs as party leader, the PLP would win. His text says, good day, Laing. Preach, just keep. No, you don't want me to preach because the other person earlier just now tell me I only talk about myself. Say, good day, Laing, preach the truth, but you, a church man, as long as the Moses crew stay in power, we will get no blessing. And on the political side, when the delegates decide, all hands on deck. Yep, that's for real. So Mr. Minnis honestly concerns me. He comes across as getting petty. I wish him well, but something isn't adding up, says a texter. His text says, Mr. Laing wasn't brave in the cabinet in the Christie administration when they put VAT on the people. Of course he was. He was the deputy prime minister at the time. But ain't nobody like VAT, so whether you put it there or you raise it, the Minnis administration, the Christie administration, they all just get one people for VAT. We have a call on the line. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
Hey, Brother Laing.
Hey, what's going on?
How you doing, man?
Right there, man.
I hear you roughing out today. Them fellas who talking with you, talking with yourself, they're really jealous of you, man. Listen to me.
I think so.
They're really jealous of you. You know, when you're small and they're jealous of the next one because they got a prettier tennis than you. You say everything but the people tennis. But listen to me, sir. First things first, BC.
Right.
We could correct BC, you know.
Okay.
Guess how they correct Patelco? They could correct BC. Bring in competition. Bring in competition on them. See, with competition do two things to you. It lower your prices and it give you better
service. And it gave you better service.
Yeah, you have to give better service. They now have competition. That was only them that could throw anything on you. Who you could go to after that? Your candle or your lamp?
That's the problem with monopolies for sure.
That's it right there. And then another thing now, with Dr. Dwayne Sands. Dr. Dwayne Sands must be one of the best doctors in the world when it comes to heart. But okay. Could you have a year like in a car? Stay in the lane.
I may not have, but he may have done so.
Okay, but stay in the lane.
Car still have spark plug?
An old car with spark. You can still get a couple of scar on your carburetor. Yeah, man. But listen to me now. Now, my closing, Dr. Minnis and Mr. Fintard. If you go with Minnis, you're down. If you go with Pintard, you don't. None of them could beat Philip Brave Davis in the 2026 election. None of them.
Yeah, you.
One might come this close. One might get more votes. But they got beat. Because what is going to happen? This morning. Then, Dr. Minnis gets beat. Minnis with the FNM, you know. But some of Dr. Minnis' people gone. I don't know where they're going, but they're gone. If Mr. Pintard wins, Mr. Pintard might stay with the FNM, but some of Mr. Pintard people gone. That is coming up in this next election year, it's going to be hard. You know politics. It's going to be hard for the FNM to beat the PLD.
You sure I know politics and you tell me?
Yeah, man, you know politics.
Okay.
You run four times, you know. You two and two.
But you
two and two.
But you.
You 50%. You buy 500.
Okay. Well. We gonna see. We gonna see for sure.
You think soon now, enough. Dr. Minnis loses the leadership on June 1st. Mr. Pintard will have a grand time going into the next election.
Let me tell you.
The way Dr. Minnis is talking, he would make sure. He'll do his endeavor to make sure the FNM doesn't win without him being leader.
I'm not afraid to take condition shouldn't define you. At Cleveland Clinic in Florida, we do whatever it takes to make life better today while discovering new treatments for a brighter tomorrow. From epilepsy management to specialized spine care and brain tumor surgery, we're delivering world-class neurology care for the day-to-day, for the days you live for every care in the world. Visit clevelandclinicflorida.org/Caribbean.
Are you a business owner or HR professional? RF's team of pension specialists are here to empower your employees with market-leading retirement solutions and to make implementing group pensions easy and cost-effective. With RF, starting or switching your company pension plan is a breeze, and there are no setup fees. If you're looking for strong investment performance and low fees, visit rfgroup.com/empower and empower your team to retire comfortably with RF Group Pensions today. That's rfgroup.com/empower.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Insurance? She hop out, pull out her phone, pull out the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang! She was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today, or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
Girl, Junior just showed me Bulla Boy in his phone.
What you mean? He take picture of that good for nothing boy?
Shh, you don't want Bulla hair. You say that. You know she always say that's my good child.
So what he doing in Junior phone?
Oh, he there because the police looking for him. He on that wanted list.
Wanted persons in your phone now?
Yes, child. And when police want find anybody quick, after something happened, they can send picture direct to your phone. Go to Google Play or App Store and search for Crack Crime Bahamas, then pick install and it will go straight to your phone.
There is also a section on missing persons.
Yes, girl. Everybody needs to get this app so police can tell us right away when these people go missing. Just like like an alert system.
Yes, it has numbers for Crime Stoppers Bahamas, so you can call and nobody knows you. Call directly to Miami and give the information without giving your name or anything about you. I tried the other day, and when I hear Junior and his boys talking about where they hide those guns, I walk quick round the corner and call that number.
Call 328-8477 from Nassau or 242-300-8477 from the Family Islands.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon. Talking about because all the power went down, all the internet went down, even BTC went down. Couldn't draw that up better than that. Anyway, so glad that we could be back to try and finish up our conversation today. And let me see if I could read the balance of these texts. This text says, as a Bahamian, I am upset. We let so much stuff go. We complain when BPL goes off or when the bill comes. We do nothing once lights back on, we forget. Same with the bill. We pay it and start complaining again next month. We let these politicians over the LP keep us backward and bend over. We need to demand more. We keep doing the same thing and expect a different outcome. We are the real conk. Where are the marches? Okay. The text says, this fellow always complaining for the PLP. I tell him, stay out of F&M business, suck my teeth. We hope the minutes win. He hope the minutes win so the PLP could win in 2026. Well, he doesn't sound like he's hoping Minutes wins, because he sounds like it don't make no difference whether Minutes wins or doesn't win to him, that the PLP is going to win anyhow. That's what he says. He says if Minutes wins, the F&M is, what did he say? Dead. And he says if Pindad wins, the F&M is doomed. So he doesn't believe that either one of those people can beat. You know, what is interesting about that perspective is this. It totally ignores what so many people believe is true about our elections for the last five elections or so, which is that nobody wins the election, but people lose it because people get kicked out and the winners become winners by default. So to his mind, he must believe that the Progressive Liberal Party's time in office would have impressed people to such a degree that they will choose to vote for them, because that's essentially what would have to happen, as opposed to vote against them, which has been the case in many instances, it seems, for the last several elections. This text says, good evening, Mr. Laing. To attempt to split the F&M's leadership would be a very old trick from the PLP's playbook. I've heard from very good sources that a well-known PLP was instrumental in assisting Branville McCartney to form the DNA in order to defeat Ingram. In that episode, it worked, so I guess they're expecting lightning to strike twice in the same spot. Well, you know, the politics can become interesting for sure. And not just between parties. You know, when I ran in a seat, I was told by my opponent after I was told,
persuasively so, and by others, that an FNM person, candidate, was, let's put it like this, unhelpful to me in my attempt to get reelected. It's human beings, man. It's human beings, right? This is how we are. We can be so very complex, right? But you know, PLPs can't split an FNM vote, and the FNM can't split a PLP vote. Only FNMs or PLPs could choose that they won't do something that you may believe is contrary to their interest. That's the only thing that could happen. You can't blame somebody if somebody goes in and votes for Pintad, votes for Minutes, because somebody in the PLP did something, said something that they thought could influence them. You can't blame the PLP for that. You have to say that person chose. These children do not mention. Adults do. These are grown people who are voting in these conventions. Right? That's why when I listen to people talk about what this one do to us and that one do to us and what we, ain't nobody do nothing to you. It is what we choose, right? I mean, people do things to you, right? But in many instances, we, when it comes to what we choose as in vote for, we can't blame nobody for that. We vote how we want to vote. And that's great because that is what freedom is. That's what free will is. That's why we get to be held accountable for our actions. Because we get to choose. Right? If you're a grown man sitting down, listening to Zhivargo Laing every day, talk about himself. Like you said. Only person in the Bible ever been in politics. You need to slap yourself. I say, how can I be so? The Texas, good afternoon, Mr. Laing. The Bahamian people already made up their minds as it relates to the PLP as a defeated and lousy administration, so it will make no difference if Mr. Pintad or Dr. Minutes is leader. They gone either way. Wow. That's a strong view. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Z Live. I owe final respects to our sponsors. And then when we come back, we'll wrap up the show. We'll be back after this break.
What boss man was saying in the back there just now.
About what? The luncheon?
Why are you always worried about food? No. About how we gotta pay a little more for natural insurance.
Mildred, you talking fool. I can't afford to pay that.
And you're always crying for him out. Ain't gonna be much. Boss still gotta pay. 1st of July, 2024.
I think that federal benefit is what did help my boy Tony through the pandemic. That same unemployment benefit. And guess what?
What?
Susan, I think she'd get a pregnancy benefit, eh?
You mean maternity benefit? Oh, we gotta do our part to make sure we get our pension. All right.
For more information, visit NIPRateIncrease.com.
For fast, reliable, and impactful printing services, look no further. Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life. We stand by our quality products that is second to none. Our affordable pricing and friendly, efficient staff makes Printmasters the ultimate choice for all your printing needs. We can deliver any type of printing services, from banners to booklets to business cards. You name it, we can print it.
Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life.
Located in the Nassau Guardian Building, telephone 302-2361.
Looking for a breakfast that will wake up your taste buds and kickstart your day? Well, Burger King Nassau has got you covered with the new Angry Crust Sandwich. Made with fluffy eggs, melted cheese, jalapenos, a spicy sauce, and your choice of ham, sausage, or bacon on a warm croissant. Make it a combo and add our signature hash browns and your choice of coffee, tea, or orange juice for a great way to start your day. Spice up your breakfast with the new Angry Crust Sandwich combo only at Burger King Nassau.
I'm not afraid, to take a stand, Everybody, come take my hand, We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.
Welcome back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. So glad you could join us for these remaining moments of the show. If in those moments you want to call us on 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259, please feel free to do so. From the Family Islands, 242-300-5720. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. This text says, glad that Jack was disconnected, talking fool. They don't believe that there's a it's fighting in the PLP also, and some want someone else in the PLP as leader. So this text says, good afternoon, Mr. Laing. We're rolling with Pintad in this election. Vote Michael Pintad to beat the PLP and Brave. Everybody's getting their campaign plug in.
That's good.
Excited. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
Hey, Zhivargo Laing. Good afternoon. How are you?
Hey, I'm good, man. How are you doing?
I'm excellent, excellent. Zhivargo, I wanted to share quickly four quick realities that seem to be dismissing here. Firstly, to the previous text who said to get rid of the Moses crew, there's no way this country can run without persons in that age category. Now, we all know that we perceive that a few of them in leadership are corrupt and is causing a lot of the issues that we are facing. We also have to look at the reality that no matter if you were to remove the Moses crew and just put the Joshua crew, that you still won't get the same result because there are a lot of young people who are corrupt and it perpetuates the same stuff. So taking the Moses crew out of the equation is not going to solve anything. The second thing is you talk about the election. A party has their base. The FNM party has their base. The only ones who decide in the election are what we term as the swing voters or the disenfranchised political supporters of either the governing party that would lend their support to the opposition party. That's how elections are won. Okay. The third part here is the power base in terms of where we talk about the direction of the country as it is right now. Unless we can find persons in this country who are, and believe you me, Zhivargo, there's still a lot of persons with integrity, especially the older people. But we have to encourage them to step up front. But we have to also realize, my third point is, the systems that we operate under are not easily changed. We have to go through these systems systematically and begin the small changes in order to get the systems to the point where we would like to see them so we could get a more prosperous country. And my last point, it comes to our new faces in these parties that want to bring their level of service toward bringing the country to where we want to see it. Again, we have to encourage these persons to not be afraid of the political landscape as it is now. Yes, we say politics is dirty, but politics is not dirty. It's the players in the politics that make the politics appear to be dirty. We need God-fearing people who care about this country first and foremost, who want to see the best for our people. And if they would be bold and stand up and come out and say, okay, well, I want to lend my service to become that change that we would like to see our country become, then I believe that would and help to drive the country towards the direction that it needs to go. So that's my 4 points. Thanks for taking my call, Zhivargo, and I'll continue to listen. God bless.
Thank you, my friend. Thank you. There's a number of points there. First of all, can I say, where do people get this move, the Moses generation concept from? From actually. Moses wasn't moved because he had old ideas. Moses wasn't moved because he was tired. Moses wasn't moved for some of the reasons we say. Moses was moved because God got upset with his deciding he get mad and vexed and decide he want to toss and break up the commandments. That's why what's this? Moses wasn't too old. God never said, "Now you're too old, I can take you." So what is that? What does that mean? If you are a functioning, capable person in leadership and in democracy, a choice of people, what's the problem? Right? Youth isn't a qualification for anything. And old isn't a qualification for anything. And youth and age can't disqualify you for anything if people want you, if they choose you. So I don't even listen to that Moses generation, Joshua generation. That's nonsense talk, right? Because God chose Moses, God chose Joshua. Problem? So if people choose Moses or people choose Joshua, what is the problem? Problem, right? I don't get that. The other thing is that our caller made the point that, you know, politics isn't corrupt. It's people who are in the politics, some of them who are corrupt. Well, the truth of the matter is, like, what system does the Bahamas have that encourages corruption or problems, that if you change it, you will not have those problems of corruption or not have as many? We have a democratic system. It based on the Westminster system of government. Okay. Let's look at the alternatives. Like, point me to an alternative that has managed to not have corruption, not have inefficiencies and all that. It's not the system that does is the problem. Because a system has people to operate it and operate within it. It's just like you said, it's people. So you could take a great system and put a unskillful person in the system and get bad results. You could take a not so good system and put a skillful person in it and you may get better results than not. Right? So in the end, many, many things fall on the quality of people you get. Right? The way they think. Right? Or don't think. You know, the morals they have, their ethical framework, their intelligence, their critical thinking skills, their affection for other human beings, their their training and experience, that all these things matter to whether a person can perform in a compelling manner. Mind you, just because people perform well doesn't mean that the people who they perform for will think they did well. Right? The last I checked, Jesus ain't do nobody nothing. In fact, he helped a lot of people, but still got stoned. If you want a more recent, more modern man example, Martin Luther King. tried to be right on the war question, sought merely to get his people to the mountaintop, even though he wasn't certain he would be there with them when they got there. Sought to love and serve humanity, and still got gunned down. So, you do the right thing because it's the right thing. And if you find, if you can discern, you find and vote for and support people you believe. You believe you'll do the right thing. It's the best you could do. And then you go home and sleep. You've been listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I'm so glad if you could join us here today. God bless you. He spares life. We'll talk to you again tomorrow. Thank you. I'm not afraid to take a stand. Take a stand.